It's time for Florida State Basketball. This is the Leonard Hamilton Show, brought to you by Coca-Cola. Try a game changer of your own. Taste the feeling. And by SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics. Now your hosts, Gene Deckerhoff and head coach Leonard Hamilton. Welcome to the Leonard Hamilton Show. We talk Florida State basketball today, our very first show of the season. And coach, 14-1, a great way to start the new year. Happy New Year.
Well, we're very pleased with our kids. They've gotten off to a good start. They're working very hard, but we just try to keep things in perspective, taking it one game at a time.
A very aggressive non-conference part of the schedule, coach. And we come out with just one little stub of the toe, and that was in a tournament at the Barclay Center where we're going to play the ACC tournament. But 14-1, coach, that's a tremendous start for this team.
No doubt about this, because we're playing a lot of new players. We have about five or six youngsters. This is their first year of playing at Florida State, and so we still have a lot of growth, progress to make. We're still learning each other. And that's the one thing that's good about this team. I think it still has a tremendous upside.
Florida State basketball right now talking about the Seminoles non-conference schedule. We'll have highlights of all of the non-conference games. You can't wait to see the top 10 highlights of the first part of our season. And, oh, by the way, ACC conference play has started. And, coach, I have never seen a conference as loaded as the ACC this year.
From top to bottom, it's an outstanding league. I'll keep saying it's the number one basketball conference ever assembled in the history of college basketball. And I think it's proven me to be right.
Highlights of the non-conference portion of the schedule and our first two ACC games are on the schedule for today's show. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Leonard Hamilton Show. We're talking Florida State basketball today. You know that. That's why you've tuned in. Let's talk about Florida State. Man, the non-conference part of the schedule, coach, very aggressive. We played that preseason NIT thing and had a chance to win the whole enchilada.
Well, we had an opportunity to play on the road. I think there's a growth part that youngsters go through not playing all their games at home.
On the non-conference part of the schedule, here's our number 10 play, and Florida State versus the Detroit Mercy Titans, a slam dunk by, how about Trent Forrest is known as a jump shooter. He's got some length, doesn't he?
Well, Trent's been a very good player for us as a freshman. He's making major contributions.
Part of a 171 victory over Detroit Mercy. The number 9 play, here we go. Arch rival Florida at the Tucker Center. And coach, this is a fast break transition effort. P.J. Savoy finds an open teammate, and there's Terrence Mann.
Well, Terrence has been a stat stuffer for us, and this is a very close game. It was in doubt there to a lot of stages of the second half. It was a very hard-fought game. We were very fortunate, and all those different plays made a big difference.
Number 8 play of the non-conference part of the schedule. We go back to the Barclay Center, and Trent Forrest comes up with one of his team-leading 26 steals, coach.
Well, he is really, really doing a very good job getting deflections and steals, and that gives us some easy opportunities to get some easy baskets.
What about that bounce pass, coach? That's about a 40-foot bounce pass. That's pretty tough to do, huh?
To his freshman Padre, C.J. Walker.
FSU beating Illinois 72-61. And capping the three-point play is Florida State's outstanding point guard. By the way, freshman to freshman on that series. Number 7 play in our non-conference portion of the schedule. How about the big fella?
Well, Chris Camargia has been a guy who's been protecting the goal there for us. He's like a goalie in soccer. He's really, really giving us a good defensive presence in the lane.
Canyon Berry thought he was going to be able to get it over the tallest player to ever wear a Florida State uniform. Not so fast, my friend, as Chris Kumaje denies. He had 2 blocks in that game against the Gators. Florida State wins 83-70. The number 6 play in our non-conference schedule. Back to the Barclay Center, coach. Again, FSU versus Illinois. An FSU inbounds play.
Here's a great pass from Rodas to Phil Colfer in the in the lane. They're playing a zone defense, and he's really, really finding him on the baseline. Those are the type of easy plays that really has a tendency to give your team a lot of momentum.
One-handed slam dunk, and nice assist, Brian Angola Rodas. Number 5 play, coach, back to the FSU-Florida game in the Tucker Center. Always a big ball game. Florida ranked number 21.
Well, here you got Bacon. He's been a guy who finds ways to score baskets each game that are very difficult for us. That was a very important basket, put it up 6, drew a foul, gave us a 7-point lead in a very, very closely contested game.
And Dwayne Bacon caps a 3-point play the old fashioned. He finished with 24 points in this ball game, and the Bacon fans are happy about that. Knowles beat Florida again. And now we go to play number 4. Here we go.
Again, back at the Tucker Center, and our number four play is FSU versus number 21 Florida again. Can't get enough highlights when you play Florida beat, can you?
Well, here's Rodas again making a three. Got fouled. I believe he went to the foul line and made it a four-point play.
Terrence Mann gets credit for the assist. You told me he's a stat stuffer coach. And here's Angola Rodas dropping in a nice little triple. He's fouled, and he caps a four-point play. You don't see those very often.
Well, there's no doubt that Rodas, along with C.J. Walker and Trent Forrest, have given us tremendous lift when they've gone in the game.
The number three play, in our opinion, of our non-conference part of the schedule, well, we take on Illinois back to the Barclays Center. And maybe the most improved player on the team, that fellow right there, Michael Ojo.
Well, Michael Ojo has really, really shown that he's really determined that he's going to leave his senior year with a bang. He's given us tremendous leadership on and off the court. He's really making a big difference during the game.
Michael had his first double-double against Winthrop, 13 points, 10 rebounds, a huge slam dunk there in that game against Illinois. The number two play, Coach, we're playing Minnesota in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. How about this? He practices every day, Coach. Over the shoulder, behind, no-look pass.
Wait, I was trying to figure out what he was going to do. We lost the ball on the floor, and Trent seemed as though he has eyes behind his head. Yeah. Eyes in the back of his head, right?
Freshman Trent Forrest, and he finds freshman Jonathan Isaac. They get the 50-50 ball on defense and a no-look pass, a thing of beauty. The number one play in our non-conference schedule, we play Sanford Bulldogs. This is just before Christmas, Coach. And how about this Christmas slam dunk?
Well, the game was a lot closer than we had hoped that it would be. Sanford did a great job. We were really, really fighting and clawing and scratching and clawing. Dwayne takes the ball to the basket. But once again, here's Terrence, Johnny on the spot.
Terrence Mann, who had a career 19 points in his first, his fifth double-figure scoring game, and slammed up with one hand offensive glass. This is a young team, Coach, that shows an awful lot of potential.
We're still growing. That's one thing that I really like about this team. They work hard together. They seem to be playing with such an unselfish spirit. We're growing. We're holding each other accountable. And I said earlier, the good thing about this team, we have a lot of room for improvement, and our attitudes have been tremendous.
12-1 in the non-conference portion of the schedule. ACC play just around the corner. In fact, we take on Wake Forest in a midweek game the Wednesday after Christmas. Highlights of that ball game coming up.
Forest slams it down for the century mark.
Loose ball on the rebound. Now it's taken away. Ahead to Mann. Mann in a foot race. His layup is up and good. And the foul on Berry.
11 inside to Bacon. He attacks the zone. His layup no good.
And what a jam!
Terrence Mann with no regard for that rim.
Welcome back to the Leonard Hamilton Show and Florida State basketball on the menu today. And Coach, ACC play, we start in the month of December, about the second earliest start to ACC conference play that I can recall.
Well, this was a very difficult game for us, Wake Forest. They got off to a tremendous start. Seemed as though they wasn't going to miss a shot. There's X driving to the basket very strong. I think we might have been behind at halftime, and we had to scratch and claw, and once again, we were able to extend the lead. Now, here's X making his 1,000 point. His father came down to witness it. It was a great day for the Mays family. There's no doubt about that.
Theron Mays, a member of the 1,000 point club, and XRM is close to joining his dad in that 1,000 point club. He's a point away as we move along into further action. Wake led by as many as 8 points in this ballgame, Coach. We had to claw back to get it close at halftime.
Well, there's no doubt that they came ready to play. We were down one at halftime. You don't know who. What's going to happen in all your ACC games, because all the teams are very, very good. Once again, there's Jonathan Isaac. He's been slowed a little bit by the fact that he had to recover from an injury, but he's getting his confidence back, and a big basket for him.
And a scoop pass to the left corner. How about C.J. Walker with a beautiful three-point shot?
Well, C.J. Walker gave us a tremendous lift coming into this game. As a freshman, you really don't expect the guy to be that far along, but he is really ready to play. There's Kamaji once again giving us a big block when we really, really needed it.
And again, a missed free throw, but Johnny on the spot, nice rebound. One of nine rebounds Jonathan Isaac had in this ballgame. And how about a reverse slam dunk by Terrence Mann? We saw that in our highlights portion of our non-conference schedule. That's a nice little slam dunk along the baseline. Use the basket to protect and go up around two big, tall guys.
Well, there's no doubt that Terrence came really ready to play. But in a game like this, when you're playing against tough competition, ACC competition, fella, you always need some extra easy plays. And Terrence always seemed to come up with a big basket for us.
Speaking of big baskets, when you need a hoop, look who goes to the rim. And what a move Dwayne Bacon just put on that defense.
It was a one-point game, could have gone either way. Dwayne gives us a very, very energized basket.
40-39 at the break, and the Seminoles are going to go to work here in the second half, Coach, and build a double-digit lead over the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. We go on a tremendous, tremendous run in the final 10 minutes of this game.
Well, Dwayne Bacon, once again, he seizes the moment. He realizes we needed a big lift from him, and he continues to keep playing well for us.
Dwayne Bacon leads the Noles in scoring, which what's new, Coach? He had 23 points in this ballgame.
Well, we needed every one of those baskets, but what happens is that Dwayne is playing so unselfish, the entire team's playing selfish. Great a pass by Dwayne. He finds C.J. Walker in the corner for a three.
Walker, the left-handed shooter, he's got that little rattlesnake release, Coach. He just drops that thing in from all over the court. He's got good range for 3 points. Now attacking the basket, how about this slam dunk by Jonathan Isaac, who finished the game with 12 points, 9 rebounds.
Well, we're still behind by 2 points, 11 minutes to go in the game. These games are always in doubt.
Down 5 now, and this is where the run begins, Coach. FSU goes to work, shot clock winding down, and a big 3-point shot by X.
Well, we're down 7 points now with under 9 minutes to go, and it seemed as though our team just exploded.
Yeah, and that junkyard defense comes to work, and the Seminoles get a fast break back. Fast break baskets are rare in this day and age in the ACC, aren't they?
There's no doubt that everyone's playing great defense, and everybody's very, very prepared. That's why every possession is important.
Well, the previous basket by Bacon tied the game, and the triple puts us up, Coach. And this is part of that huge run, 19-6 run after that 8-minute mark. Again, that big defense denying the easy layup.
Well, I think our players are really, really feeling that they need to play hard. They're seizing the moment. They're playing very well together. They're cheering for one another. They're taking advantage of every opportunity.
Again, defense leads to offense, transition hoop, and driving their lane. And nobody can deny Dwayne Bacon. He has tremendous athleticism when he attacks the rim, doesn't he?
Well, playing hard together, getting some deflections, getting steals, is making a big difference. Getting everybody involved, playing with a tremendous amount of energy. Now we stand in the lead of 10 points with 5 minutes to go. You see the entire bench, the fans, the crowds, all involved. Our players are really responding to them. It was a very good night for us.
Up 8 points, and Dwayne Bacon doing his thing. Can't get it to go, but there's a one-handed, left-handed stick back by Jonathan Isaac. He's multi-talented.
Well, he has a knack for just being around the basket, getting those tip-ins. Like I said earlier, we need some of those easy baskets, some of those baskets that sometimes you don't plan for, but the guys are delivering them because they're hustling and working hard.
We shoot the ball extremely well at home, 50% plus, and our three-point shooting, 36%. Two guys score 23 points. Xavier Ratan Mays, his dad was there to see him join that 1,000-point club. Thank you very much, Theron Mays, for sending your son to Florida State, and Dwayne Bacon with 23.
Well, we had to really, really claw and scratch, and to overcome a 47% three-point shooting by Wake Forest, we had to do a lot of things right, and we were able to extend the lead. And I was very fortunate and very happy to come with that victory.
Florida State outscores Wake by 17 in the second half, 88-72, the final score. Next up, a road trip to Charlottesville, Virginia. Florida State takes on the 11th-ranked Virginia Cavaliers. You don't want to miss the highlights of this game. Stick around. Welcome back to the Leonard Hamilton Show. We promised you highlights of Florida State's thrilling victory over the Virginia Cavaliers. And, Coach, when you go on the road in the ACC, you're battling a team, you're battling the crowd, you're battling the name on the other team's jersey. And Florida State taking on a team that very seldom loses on their home court, the John Paul Jones Arena in Charlottesville.
Well, there's no doubt that Virginia has probably the best fans in our conference. They are very knowledgeable. They cheer and boo on it just about any and everything. It's a very tough place for us to play.
Coach, we start really, really well. We build a nice lead at 10-2. And defense, we show Virginia we could play defense too, don't we?
Virginia's a very good basketball team, and they have had tremendous success, especially at home over the years.
Philip Kofor on a stick back off a missed layup, and Phil getting some playing time here in the first half of John Paul Jones. And, Coach, You talk about junkyard defense, and that's what it looks like this year. This defense is really opportunistic. They knock the ball away. They get fast break baskets.
Well, Virginia has been one of the better defensive teams in the country year in and year out, and we had to really work hard to get every basket.
Yeah, they talk about the pack line defense, Coach. It always takes a nice little bounce like that. When that three-point shot looked like it was coming out, and you get the three-point shot, it counts. Every basket's important when you play an ACC road game, isn't it?
Well, that's a kick out by Chris Camargi. I just tell you, he's getting better and better with each game.
And Trent Forrest doesn't play like a freshman, does he?
No, he really does not. He's a very smart-headed player who's making major contributions to our team.
We had an early lead. Virginia takes control. They're up by 7 at halftime, and we got to claw our way back to try to win on the road.
One thing that is good about the ACC, every night out, you know you're going to be playing against a tough opponent.
Terrence Mann, a little step-back floater, and he gets harmed as well. And Michael Ojo, when he gets the ball in his hand, it's tough to take it away from him. He's got the biggest hands I've ever shaken. And Dwayne Bacon goes to work. He had 3 points in the first half, Coach, 26 points in the second half. Did the light switch go on in the locker room?
No, we needed every one of his baskets. No doubt about that.
Well, he got red hot, particularly his three-point shooting in this ballgame. He was 6 of 9, a career best, 6 made three-point shots.
Well, Dwayne's getting better and better. There's no doubt that he has improved his perimeter shooting.
Now, you very seldom get a triple out of the guy wearing number 0, but Philip Cooper right in front of you, he almost stepped on your toe, Coach.
Well, Phil has worked very hard on all phases of his game. Now, he was a very important basket. We're down 4 points, and with 2 or 3 seconds on the shot clock, and we get a nice jump shot from Dwayne. So we needed that.
So nice, we're going to watch it again. Inbounds pass, a little stick back. He knew it. He just beat the shot clock. You saw the shot clock hit 0.
Well, it was 1 or 2 seconds on the shot clock. There's no doubt that basket was important.
Get a defensive stop, rebound by Jonathan Isaac, and the Seminoles go to work now, trailing by 2. There's a big triple by Dwayne again. I told you he made a career best 6 3-point shots in this ballgame. He was on fire, as they say.
And we needed every one of his baskets in order to win this game.
Now, in the end, Coach, a seesaw thing. What a move on the baseline. It's not just 3-point shots. Dwayne Bacon has got the total package.
Well, that was a steal on an inbounds pass, and that was easy. That was a very, very important basket and a very critical part of the game.
Here he is again, a leaner in the baseline area, and he gets the bottom of the net now. That ties the ball game at 51-51. Free throw shooting, Coach, 50%.
Big play by Jonathan Isaac, giving us a loose ball and giving Dwayne an opportunity to score another basket.
Now watch it again, the missed shot, the free throw. We're 6 of 12.
He had the presence of mind to keep that ball alive. We missed the free throw and got us another easy basket on a hustle play.
Now they know Bacon is the guy, Coach. And with 2 minutes to go, Dwayne's going to put up another three. This was a contested three-point shot. When you're hot, you're hot.
Well, it gave us a little breathing room, but Virginia was not going to be denied. They came right back on us and tied the game.
Yeah, this is a team that had a 37-game win streak snapped by West Virginia earlier. Here's a triple from the corner, and that's the game winner. That gives Florida State a 60-58 win to Wayne Bacon from the deep quarter. There it is.
Wow, I'm amazed. I'm excited. I'm getting goosebumps just watching that again. We needed that basket. There's only 2 seconds on the shot clock, and very, very important road victory for our basketball team.
Yeah, that was the game winner. They had taken the lead on a triple. Here's Perantes with a prayer from half court. And it's kind of come close, but no cigar. Knowles win. Knowles win on the road in Charlottesville. Coach, we hadn't won up there in a while.
Well, that's a tough place to play. They're a very good basketball team. They're very well coached. They're always well prepared. But it was a hard-fought game. Both teams worked very hard. We were very fortunate to get that last shot to go in.
Virginia ranked number 11. Florida State notches a road win against a ranked team, improves to 2-0 in ACC conference play. The season is young. We'll talk about the week ahead in just a moment. Welcome back to the Leonard Hamilton Show, Coach. A lot of highlights today. Those non-conference highlights at the top of the show were exciting to relive. And how about that thrilling win over Virginia?
Well, there's no doubt that we entered the ACC race. Every team is working very hard. They all have improved. We've had a lot of what they call upsets, but I remind you, there are no upsets in the ACC because all the games are very competitive.
The week ahead, Florida State takes on the Virginia Tech Hokies at the Tucker Center Saturday at 2 o'clock, and a huge crowd saw us beat Wake Forest, and you're looking for a big crowd when Virginia Tech comes.
No doubt about that, because we're going to need the 6th man in the stands to help us through that game.
And then, oh, by the way, I think on Tuesday, Florida State hosts the Duke Blue Devils. So we got a big week ahead, don't we?
No doubt about that. We need both victories, and we need our fans in the stands.
ACC basketball, nothing like it. The only thing better is Florida State basketball. That's why we talk about FSU hoops here on the Leonard Hamilton Show. That's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week right here talking FSU basketball.
This has been the Leonard Hamilton Show, brought to you by Coca-Cola. Try a game changer of your own. Taste the feeling. And by SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics.